All right, so, you know, this is kind of your last, I don't want to call it a warm-up, but your last game before you go to Connecticut for the really heavy ones. What do you like so far, and what still has to be cleaned up, you feel like, both sides of the ball?
Yeah, I think we've definitely shown improvements game to game and where we were at probably a month ago and everything like that. But, you know, there's a lot of good areas that we've been playing in. I think our inside game has been really tough to guard, and our ability to feed them the ball inside. And we've really made some shots from the perimeter too, and how people are doubling and people guarding, everything like that. We've really worked on executing plays a lot better. Mm-hmm. But I think from the other side of the ball, I think that's a major part that we can improve upon, and just, you know, always knowing our defensive assignment, making sure we keep our man in front. Help side defense, we've been kind of lacking in that area, but it's always something that teams struggle with early on, but, you know, we're going to improve throughout the year. So,
as one of the leaders, with all the offensive success you guys have had and all the weapons you have, mm-hmm. do you have to, I guess, get out in front of people thinking that, hey, we can just outscore everybody?
Yeah, 100%. I think you're going to run into teams that are very talented that, you know, are going to be great on both sides of the ball. So, yeah. You know, for us, making sure that, you know, obviously we need to execute and be efficient offensively, but on the defensive side of the floor, like, we got to stop people. That's what, you know, that's what great teams do, and that's how great teams win. And, you know, when you start getting into Big Ten season and some of these big non-conference games, you'll see that teams can really score the ball, and they have a lot of different options. So making sure that we shore up that side of the floor, I think, is going to be really big for us moving on.
Just with the amount of weapons you have, it feels like the pieces are kind of falling in place here. Do you see guys kind of understanding roles right away here, and you know, not really trying to do too much, understanding that we've got, you have all this stuff around you?
Yeah, 100%. I think that's kind of a big concern going into the season. It's just, we have a lot of talent. We have a lot of guys that could do a lot of different things, and really understanding roles and understanding your job is important on this team. And I think, you know, within these first few games, you've kind of seen guys kind of settle in and everything. And nothing's ever, you know, a sure thing. Mm-hmm. And different people are going to step up every single game and give us great games and big contributions. But yeah, I thought everybody's done a great job of understanding their role, picking their spots, taking good open shots is a big thing for us, and feeding the open man. And I thought we've done a good job. And also knowing your role on the defensive end of the floor. Yeah. If you're a guy that comes in and gives a spark on that side of the floor, I think you could make a huge impact for our team.
Yeah, these first two games, and I guess these next two games, you and Ethan are sort of the backup fours. What's that like, being more of a backcourt guy, but, you know, having to play it? And I understand you're not playing like Karl Malone or anything like that, but just what's the transition there? What's kind of different for you and him when you're out there?
Yeah, it was one thing I definitely didn't assume I'd be playing the four here in college, but no, it gives us a lot of different looks. It provides a different feel for us on the offensive side of the floor. We're able to go four guards, and, you know, as long as we know what we're doing in that position, and you know, the you know, guarding personnel and everything like that from the defensive side of the floor, I think we're going to be okay. But yeah, I think Ethan's done a great job of, he kind of fits that mold a little better. He's a little bigger and stronger than me in that post and boxing out and stuff like that. But yeah, I think, you know, just learning that position, getting more comfortable with it throughout these next few weeks and going into the full year, I think we'll get a lot better at that position as well.
And I'd imagine Carolina is going to have a dude at that position, and you guys are going to have to.
Yeah.
Guys are going to have to be pretty physical.
Yeah.
What's that going
to
be like?
Yeah, no doubt. You have to be prepared for anything that happens. Obviously, right. A lot of different things, foul trouble, injuries, you know, certain matchups. Yeah, you have to be ready for it. Obviously, you know, there's going to be guys, pretty much everybody, if I play at that position, is going to be bigger than me, unless right. they're going small as well. So just being prepared to be physical at that position, box out, you know, whatever it may be, fight the post, make sure no post catches. I think you got to be prepared for it, and it's probably going to happen sooner rather than later.
Do you practice at the four?
Not really. No, just based on personnel with, you know, we have our scout teams and a lot of people in that position still, but no, we really don't. Just running through plays.
How do you know what to do?
Really just kind of understanding the system. I think I played a little bit of the four too my freshman year, just random positions.
That's right.
Yeah, and just kind of picking it up, I think you know, being able to play on the floor, you got to know everybody's position. So I feel pretty confident that I know 1 through 5 well enough where I could play any of those positions. I don't think I will be, but yeah, just learning it all like that.
They can put you at center now too, huh?
I guess. I don't think we need me there ever. Yeah.
Cool.